going on, guys, and welcome back to another video. I hope you're having a great week. I know I am, and I do apologize for the echo. It's inside my garage. I ended up closing the door. There's way too much outside noise going on with everybody driving by and making noise, and it just didn't sound right for the video. Anyway, let's get straight into it. So I ended up buying my car used, and I really didn't think it was worth going to a dealership and paying a full sticker price of this car when I know that they depreciate so fast and there's a ton of them coming out. Unless you have like a ZR1 that's coming out and maybe those will keep their value a lot better, I really don't think it's worth it. So I ended up saving myself $32,000 by getting this one, and it is fully loaded. It's got the 3LT, I got the track suspension on it, I got the full custom interior, I got every option fully loaded. Now, I didn't have the side skirts, I didn't have the front lip, but that was later. I added all that later. That was easy to do. But besides that, I got all the important things I wanted in the car. When I did buy this car, it looked nothing like the way it looks right now. Here's actually a picture of what it looked like the first day I bought it. Now, as you can see in the picture, this car looks nothing like the way it did when it was stock. Right away, I started modifying it. I wasn't messing around. I already knew what I wanted to do to it, and I just went with it. When it came to modifying the car, especially the exterior appearance, I didn't want to go overboard. I didn't want to take away from the original look of the car. All I did is want to enhance the actual features that they came with. I wanted it to look like it was OEM, but very aggressive and subtle, so that it doesn't look so plain, it doesn't look so stock. A lot of people end up overdoing it when it comes to modifying a car. Little subtle things make a big difference, and a lot of people go overboard, and then what ends up happening is that they depreciate the car even more. It's a lot harder to sell, and it doesn't look right. The body lines don't flow, so that's why I just chose this route. And on top of all of that, I ended up doing the supercharger kit on it. I just added a lot more horsepower, so that it does bring it up to a Z06 level. The way that this car sits with the supercharger and all the packages, let's say you bought a Z06 with all the packages that I have on this car, off the lot, this car will run you about $110,000 to $120,000 plus taxes. And I really don't think at this time in my life it's worth spending that much money when I got all of that for a lot less. If I do include the supercharger and all the modifications that I did to this car and the price that I paid for it, with the taxes, $65,000, and it did have 18,000 miles on it when I bought it. So that's still a lot less than a base model Z06 with a cheaper interior, with no aero package, just a base model. Still haven't answered your question, how much did I pay for the car? Before all the modifications, before anything that was done to the car, I ended up paying $56,000, that is with taxes, right out of the door. And after modifying the car and spending an additional $9,000 to upgrade it and modify it, that brings me up to 65 grand, which is still way cheaper than going the other route. Because think about it, I'm driving a $65,000 car that has all the same features as a $100,000+ Z06. And am I any happier? Who cares? I get the same features, same performance, same luxuries in this, and I save myself $40,000. Shit, right now at like $45,000, you can get yourself a used C7 Corvette. So, hey, at the end of the day, I thought that was a financially a better decision, and I get to enjoy having a really cool sports car. And I hope this clears up a lot of you guys' questions. And if it's your first time stopping by, subscribe to the channel. Take care and be safe.